Hey guys, so today we are going to make our own live wallpapers using free apps that you can download on the App Store. Live wallpapers have been a feature on iPhones 6s and above. Right now this is the 10s Max, and I'm not usually someone that ventures off of the stock wallpaper. Usually the wallpaper that Apple intended is the one that looks the best on the phone. So I usually don't change it, except for this wallpaper. Just look at this. What is this? It looks like the world if the Visco girls don't save the environment from plastic pollution. So, today, I am on a quest to make my wallpaper look less like Chernobyl and more serene. So let's do it. We're gonna make three different types of wallpapers today. One of them is a professional type wallpaper, one that kind of mimics the stock wallpapers. The second one is a wallpaper of a person or a pet, and the third is a live wallpaper of a static photo. So we are going to be animating static photos and then turning that into a live wallpaper. And we are going to be using three apps, and the apps are PixArt, Pixaloop, and Into Live. And I will link all of these apps in my description, and they each play a vital role in making your live wallpapers look great. So first, I'm going to open PixArt, and then I'm going to make a new one and scroll down to Drawings and then Pick Canvas and then scroll over to whatever your screen size is and then click Next. And then we are going to pick the rectangle tool down on the bottom and then just click on a shape that you want. So I'm going to change the color of it to maybe that, and then change the shape to that, and then drag it through the full screen. Okay, so now that that is on the full screen, we're going to press the next button and click Edit Image. So then we are going to go into Effects, Pop Art, Color Gradient. And then you can pick your colors that you want it to stick to. I'm going to go blue to more blue. And then it just looks like a nice gradient right there. So then I'm going to click Apply, Next, Save. Save to my device. Now, we are going to open this picture in Pixaloop. Go to New Project and import the picture you just made. Now, we can click an overlay, bring that opacity down so that there's clouds just a little bit. Okay, so it's like this nice gradient right there. I don't know if it'll focus. It won't focus, it never does. But you'll see it on the screenshot. And there's the clouds. We could even do a sunset actually, but I think the sky number one is better. And then we are going to save it as a video. And then the final step will be to open Into Live. And then all these ads, I'm just like, what? Okay, there we go. Okay, so then that is there. And you can click on which one you want it to stick to. So I might pick the key photo to be right there, okay? So we're gonna go into Make. No repeat, because then you have to pay for that. And then it lets you preview it, which is great. So you long press, it's beautiful. So save live photo, close add, saved photos, and then go to settings, wallpaper, choose a new wallpaper, live photos. It's so much better than the other one. Okay, so we did the first live wallpaper. Now we are going to move on to the second type, which is a person or a pet. And I really recommend using a video for this. And going forward, I recommend if you plan on using something as your live wallpaper in the future, I recommend taking it as a video and not a live photo, because then it gives you a lot more control. So we are going to open back up into live, and we are going to pick a video, and I actually have one of my dog. First, you click the video. And then I'm going to trim this video. So I'm going to trim it to where I want my dog to show. So he's just going to be happy. Aww. And then we are going to click on the canvas feature. And that is one of the best features of this app. And you're going to click the lock screen one. That is one of the greatest features about this app, is that you can stretch it and you can have it fit the screen. So right there, probably. And we're gonna stretch his face so that it makes the wallpaper. And then we're gonna click key photo at the bottom, and I'm gonna click on the photo that I want to be the wallpaper before you long press. So it's probably gonna be this one of him smiling. And then you can even add text or stickers. This app is amazing. It's very versatile. And I'm gonna click make, no repeat, and then it's going to make a preview of it. And then I'm gonna click save live photo, click out of the ad when it times out, and then go to settings, wallpaper, choose new wallpaper, camera roll, and dog. And that's just a rough cut, but I mean, that's like, it just looks so nice, like having him be my wallpaper. So now we are on to the third type of wallpaper. And this one is going to be fun. So we are going to animate a still photo. So for that, you're going to open Pixel Loop, and then you're gonna click New Project, find the photo that you want. So for me, I actually have one in mind. I went to this garden center that I really love recently, and I have a picture that I really want to use. So I have this. So you click on anchor points. So I'm gonna do the plants. 2, 3. And then you draw a path. So I want these plants to grow upward. And then it does this kind of trippy growing upward of the plant, and you can make it go shorter. So say I only want the leaves to grow. So I want to animate all of these leaves, and I'm gonna freeze the pots so that the pots aren't growing and the surroundings around it. But the plants themselves, when you tap on them, will grow. So I'm just gonna freeze the entire background. Rough draft, but whatever. And then, okay. So I'm freezing the entire background, and now I'm going to pick more anchor points. So let's pick boom, boom, boom. And then path, upward, anchor point, boom, boom, path, up, up. Okay, now I need to freeze the pot in here. And the little pots here, and that table. Now I'm gonna just keep animating them. And it's kind of trippy. I mean, I didn't spend that much time on this. If I had more time, then I would change it, but this is kind of cool within itself. So then when we play it, the plants are moving in a kind of cool way. So then I'm gonna save it as a video, export. And then we are gonna open into Live again. And we are going to click on the video we just made. Okay. Then we're gonna click on that. And then I'm gonna click my key photo, which will be the first one. And then I will click make. No repeat. So as you can see, by itself it's static, but if I wanted to long press on it, the plants are moving. In a trippy way. Not in like an organic way per se, but it's okay. We did what we could. And I mean, if you spent a long time on it, you could get it better. But for right now, this is great. So then I'm gonna save live photo, wait for the ad to close. Okay, then go into settings, wallpaper, live photos, this one. And then you can see it move again. And I mean, yes, it is kind of like a strange movement, but not when you do it like that. Like, that looks kind of cool. So then let's see. Tapping on it will get it to move. So yeah, that was it. We did 3 live wallpapers. They were all kind of rough edits, but it just shows you what you can do with the apps on your phone. You can make your own live wallpapers, so you're not stuck with the green Chernobyl world that I was stuck with for 10 months because I kept tricking myself into telling myself that I liked it because I love Apple. So now I have plants that grow in a trippy way, and I could do my dog, or I could do the cool one with the clouds at the beginning that was really serene and calm. So yeah, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below anything you'd like to see in the future. And if you like this type of video, let me know. And subscribe. I put out a new video every Thursday, and subscribing means a lot to me. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.